The first thing we need to do is open the image in Touch Retouch, because I want to get rid of the elements, some of the elements on the beach. So I'm going to tap on Albums. I know I've saved it in my favorites. And what I really liked about this photograph was the cloud coming across that great blue sky, and the woman and her dog were just walking into the light cast on the sea there, so they were nicely outlined. And also I loved the way the light was catching these waves as they crashed onto the shore in kind of intervals. There's kind of bright bit, then a darker blue, and then a bright bit. So that was really nice as well, just delineating the line of the shore. So the first thing when I'm looking at an image like this is there anything that doesn't contribute to the image, anything that distracts, anything that doesn't really look great, like this little kind of blob of people that aren't really defined. So to me, that just looks like a bit of a dirty blob. No offense to the people, dirty blob on the beach. So I'm going to get rid of those first of all. I'm going to tap on object removal, and I'm just going to paint, make my brush a little bit bigger, paint around the people here, just quite loosely. Maybe make my brush a little bit bigger, just around the outline. And then press the magic button, go, and the people magically disappear. Now I see that's left a little bit of a funny kind of grey over that yellow area there. So I'm going to go into the clone tool, pick up the clone stamp, tap on the bit that I'm going to copy, and then I'm going to paint in this grey area to the right of that white circle. So if I just tap and press, you'll see that clones that across. I want a softer brush, so I'm going to take the hardness down and then just increase the size a little bit. And then I'm going to come in here again. Just use the back button if I make a mistake. Position that about there. I'm going to up the opacity and up the size. I'm going to zoom back to try and get a bigger brush and just continue that on until it gets to the edge. Now I've got another figure in here which I don't really want, so I'm going to go in and clone him out as well. And it's just a case of tapping on the area that you want to clone by tapping your pencil or finger anywhere, and then wherever you brush after that is going to be the texture or whatever you've tapped on. I'm going to use the back button at the top to go back, and I'm going to pick something really close. It's usually better to use something as close as possible, because then the tone is going to be nearer to what you're painting, so it's going to be more realistic. So here I'm just trying to paint, repeat what's happening in this blue space here on the left. I'm trying to repeat it on the right. Now remember, this is very far away in our picture, and we're going to use other apps to stylize it, so you don't have to be really precise. As long as you get the overall kind of feeling that this is the same kind of color shade, that will be enough. And like I said, it's very far away as well, so unless someone's going to zoom in really, really close, and even then, it's highly unlikely they'll notice the difference. And I'm just going to try and repeat this shape, this corner here, on this one here. Sometimes it takes a couple of tries, but that doesn't look too bad at all. And it's just having confidence, having faith that that's going to all work out. Okay. Let's just take that brush size down a bit. Like I say, sometimes it just takes a couple of goes to just get the right position. Okay, that's great. Next, I'm going to go in and just remove this shadow on here. I'm doing this quite quickly just for demonstration purposes, but normally I might take a little bit longer just to get that just right. And again, I'm going to use the object removal just to remove the figure of this guy, and then it will do it automatically for me. Just paint over the figure, tap on go, and there it does it for you. You can see there's a couple of little light marks there, so I'm just going to get rid of those. Let's try object removal. Perfect. There's another little bit at the end. Gone. Brilliant. Okay, so now we have our edited image and we've got rid of all those elements. It's time to go into the next app. Next, I brought the image into iColorama and I went onto the style, then flow menu, and then tapped on the 411 preset. And this gave this lovely kind of whirring, blurring effect. And I really like what it did to the clouds. Now, I took the bleach right down on the left-hand side and I left the other sliders, the highlight and the shadows, just about in the middle, and the opacity on full. But what I did after that is the image of the figure and the dog were kind of wiped out. So I used the brush mask to bring those back. So tap on the brush mask on the left-hand side, and then if you tap on zoom on the left-hand side and zoom right into the figure, and I'm just using my fingers to expand the screen and then one finger to push the figure back into view, and then tap off zoom move and then just start to bring that figure back. Now you can see that was much too big, that brush, but I can go back into the mask menu, the floating menu, just here, and tap on erase and then just paint that mask back. Don't worry if you keep going over it, it's just a case of changing the brushes, going between paint and erase, taking the brush size down and then bringing back the figure. And then I'm going to go into the dog, find the dog. I'm going to paint right over him because I couldn't see where he was, and I can go in with the erase button, make sure the brush is really small, and then paint back in, and just do it roughly because we're going to make a little bit more of this dog when we end in Procreate at the end of this process. And I'm literally just trying to just blur in around his legs and just bring back that definition a little bit. Double tap to zoom the frame right back to its original size. So we've defined the figure and the dog a little as well. So next we're going to save that. And we're going to tap apply to apply the effects we've just applied. Save as PNG because that's a good high res version. And next we'll make the color adjustments. The next thing I did is move from the style menu into the adjust menu to adjust the color. I wanted to make it look a lot brighter. I think the foreground is very dark and I just wanted to make it look like more of a dreamy, light, surreal kind of landscape. So I chose Tone Lab and up the saturation to quite high, and then just took the bias down on the bottom sliders to about there. And you can see that's making it much more bright. It's taken a lot of the black out of the picture and just given this lovely luminous glow, which is exactly what I was after. So then I applied that and then saved that down as a PNG. And next we'll go into Procreate just to give a bit of definition to the little figures on the beach there. So finally I opened up Procreate, imported the last photo I adjusted in iColorama. And what I really wanted to do here was crop it, but also give a little bit of definition to the dog here. You can't really see him that well. Maybe give him a little bit of a tail and maybe just clean up the figure here as well. So the first thing I did was crop the image by going to the canvas and then crop and resize. So I'm just going to bring the crop in from the right hand side and I just want to clip it about where those clouds kind of finish about there. And we've got a lot of blue up here, so I'm just going to take that down a little bit. And what I'm aiming for is the figure more or less to be on this little kind of intersection here. I'm also going to bring it a little bit up from the bottom to give it more of a landscape feel. And then I'm going to tap on done. And finally, let's go in and give a little bit of definition to this dog. So first thing I'm going to do is tap on the dog to pick up his color. And then I'm going to go into brushes and pick an airbrushing brush on about a medium brush. I'm going to pick a new layer. And then I'm going to test the brush by just drawing over it. Two finger tap to go back. The brush was obviously massive, so I need to bring that brush size down. I'm going to tap to pick up the colour, and then I'm just going to take that brush size right down and then just paint in the dog, just very roughly. You don't need to be an amazing artist just to draw these little legs on here. And I'm also going to give him a little tail coming up there as well to give him a bit more definition. And then I'm going to pick up the colour around and just go in and paint roughly inside the legs again to bring out those legs so we can see the little dog a little bit more clearly. Keep zooming back to see if that's made any difference. Yeah, and you see it looks a little bit light there. So I'm going to pick up this slightly darker brown by tapping my finger on the surface and then just colouring in. Maybe make it a little bit more darker, and that's looking better. Of course, the other thing you can do is to use this brilliant little smudge tool and just smudge around the edges. It's another way of sort of blending a darker image in with a lighter image. I'm going to pick up this colour, make sure I'm on the brush tool, just come in a little bit closer. Okay, so now we've got the dog nicely defined. I might even give him a little bit more of an ear going up. Again, giving him just that little bit more definition. And there it is, that's the finished illustration. We've taken a photograph, we've given it a nice flow in iColorama, and then we cropped it, and then we adjusted the colour again in iColorama with the Tone Lab just to brighten it and give it that nice dreamy light feel. And then finally we came into Procreate just to give a little bit more definition to the figures and the dog. And finally, just to see what this would look like with a little slightly more saturated sky, I went into Snapseed, tap selective, and added a bit more saturation in the top and right hand corners, which I thought worked quite well and kind of evened out the colour tones. And that's it. Thanks for watching. I'll be creating more videos like these, and I would love to hear any questions you have about my work or techniques. I hope you found this tutorial useful and inspiring. And if you'd like to learn more about how I create my work and the techniques I use, you might like to try one of my mobile art video courses. All the links to the courses are below. And also, please hit the subscribe button below this video to be notified of more creative mobile art tutorials coming up soon. You can also follow my latest mobile art projects on social media, where I regularly give out mobile art related prizes. And again, the link is just below. Thank you so much for watching, and I look forward to your comments and questions below. This is Nikki Fitzgerald at iPhonography Central.